द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रांसफार्मर। पूरा पेपर तो इजी था, आई थिंक दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन जो लोगों को थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम किया होगा, बट ठीक है, इट्स ओके। अगेन इट इज़ द सिंपल पार्ट इफ़ यू नो द बेसिक। सपोज वी हैव अ ट्रांसफार्मर एंड इन बिटवीन देर इज़ अ एयर गैप इन द कोर। तो वॉट विल हैपन इफ़ यू प्रोवाइड द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इन करेंट हेयर, दैट इज़ कॉल्ड, दिस इज़ योर, सपोज करेंट इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू द वाइंडिंग एंड हैविंग द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इन, so we can say this is called ampere turns. Ampere turns will be equal to n into I. Generally we are saying this is also called mmf in terms of numerical. So generally we say hl is equal to n into I, so all are called mmf. And in the magnetic circuit mmf is equal to, or flux is equal to MMF upon reluctance. This is the basic relation in case of magnetic circuit. So I am going to use all this basic term. Now you can see when we applying the number of turns and current here, the flux will flow through this core as well as air gap. So for this flux there are two paths, that is your core and second is air gap. So there are two different material, so it's quite obvious when two different material are connected in series, their resistance are added. So similarly in the magnetic circuit, the total reluctance will be equal to the reluctance of the core plus the reluctance of the air gap. So reluctance of core will be equal to the length of the air core, or length of the core upon mu naught mu r a, area of the cross section, plus length of the air gap plus mu naught, because this is air gap, the relative permittivity will be equal to 1, and it is having the same area of cross section. This is the total reluctance of this magnetic circuit. So I am going to use this relation, this one, MMF is equal to, sorry, N into Y is MMF, should be equal to MMF, MMF is phi into reluctance. So overall, first case, MMF should be equal to the flux flowing through the path, and this is a total reluctance. Now I am going to use this. Now we will read the question, what is given. Now you can see the same pattern. The transformer is here. There is an air gap of 0.2 centimeter. The first statement is, this is all are similar, it's okay. The leakage and fringing are negligible. This is not read this question. Has uniform cross sectional area. It means chahe wo air gap ho, chahe wo sara section ho, sabhi jagah pe cross sectional area is same. It doesn't matter, koi farak padega nahi. Jo total periphery hai wo 40 cm ka hai, and quite soon 10 yahan par hai, 10 yahan par hai, 10 yahan par, 10. So 40 should be the total. Now, first case is given when the core permeability is infinite. The first case, core permeability is infinite. The magnetic flux density computed in the air gap is 1 Tesla. First statement. So MMF I can use N into I. Phi is given by flux density. So first case, this is the area of cross section. Total reluctance kab bol raha hai, when the relative permittivity of the core is infinite. So agar main yahan par infinite put karu, it quite obvious this term will be zero. So total mein kya bachega, length of the air gap upon mu naught into A. This is the first. Now, second statement, it is saying when the relative permittivity is changed to 1000, then the flux density round off to 3 decimal. Now, for same ampere turns, we are not going to change the ampere turns, that is Ni. MMF is still constant, should be equal to the new flux density. And we are not going to change the apparatus or transformer, so area of cross section will remain same. Ab yahan par dono reluctance aa jayega, length of the core upon mu naught mu r upon a plus length of the air gap upon mu naught into 1 into a. This is the second equation. Now in the question it is given we have same ampere turns, so ampere turns will be same. So I am going to use this one. So we are getting B1 into A length of the air gap upon mu naught into A should be equal to B2 into A. Now we have the length of the core upon mu naught mu r A plus length of air gap upon mu naught into 1 into A. Now you can see the most of the terms are common, mu naught into A, mu naught into A, all are common. The value of B1 is given, area is not given, it's not necessary. The flux density is given, kitna given hai jab hamare paas infinite given hai, that is 1 tesla. 1 tesla, it's okay. So 1 into length of the air gap is 0.2, it's okay, yahan to cancel ho gaya. Now B2 we are going to find. Now we have the length of the core, total is 40, out of which the air gap is 0.2, the remaining will be 39.8 centimeter. So 39.8 upon mu r, so mu r is 1000 plus 0.2 upon 1. So from this we can find the value of new flux density, that should be equal to 0.2 B2, that should be equal to 0.2 plus 0.0398. Now if I put all this value, I am getting this risk. After putting all the values, I am getting 0.8348 tesla. So round off to 2 decimal, you can use 0.835, whatever, doesn't matter. If you put this one, it is also correct. So this is the total flux density if we consider the relative permittivity of the core.